First up, who doesn't love sweet and sour? I'm going to batter a delicious selection of veg.
So, we'll start with prepping the veg. Let's take our base off of our cauliflower. And we're looking for little morsels that are going to be dipped in the batter and then deep fried. Now, I would say that's probably about perfect. So you're talking about a golf ball size. I've never played golf in my life.
Some delicious broccoli. Same rules apply. These red peppers will bring a hit of colour.
Oyster mushrooms. These I use a lot of in my cooking. And you can get them from all Westerns, well, most Western supermarkets. They're such a good vegetable to use because they're really, really chunky. And they're almost like a meat replacement. So I'm gonna half them, and I'm gonna do the top end as one, but then I'm gonna cut the stalks in half. And they're gonna be beautiful fried up.
Making the batter couldn't be simpler.
Now, this batter is a bit of a hybrid batter. So plain, normal fish and chip shop batter, you'd have your plain flour, your bicarb of soda, and you'd have water in, a tiny bit of salt. Then a tempura batter, you would then replace the water with sparkling water. It makes it fizzy, which is what makes it a bit crispier.
For a bit of Gok flair and flavour, use a Chinese beer instead of soda water. So 400 grams of plain flour.
Good. Sprinkling of salt. We want to give that batter some flavour. Bicarb of soda. Put about a teaspoon in there.
Then half a litre of beer.
Look at that. Look at all that fizz.
Perfect for a crispy batter.
Just work out the lumps a little bit. You could, if you wanted to, add some chili powder or some paprika or some cayenne pepper to this batter now, and that adds another little flavour. So it's always thinking about outside of the box. Those little twists are incredible. And a little top tip, write them down. If you create a meal or you do a dish and you turn it into your own, write down the difference that you've made and keep a little book of that, because that is really precious. And in years to come, that'll be passed down to your kids and then the grandkids. It's one of the best gifts to share. Okay, so that's kind of the consistency. That's how quick it is. You want it to run off of your whisk.
For the fry, fill a wok with 1.5 inches of vegetable oil and whack it onto a medium heat.
You've got to remember, we've got to cook the veg in that oil. We're not going to blanch it first. So you don't want it to be too hot, but you want it to be hot enough so the batter gets crispy.
Oh, they look gorgeous, don't they?
Look at that one. You see where that cauliflower's browned. Right, I think these ones are done.
Once you're happy, fish them out. Rest them on some kitchen towel and onto the next.
What's really nice about the pepper is you get to see the red colour of the pepper coming through.
Repeat with the broccoli. Then finally, the delicious meaty oyster mushrooms.
It's so lovely. That batter's really, really light. And you can taste the veg as well. And honestly, fried broccoli, deep fried broccoli, what's not to love? But these are the ones that I'm waiting for, my favourite. I love king oyster mushrooms.
You can keep the cooked veg warm in the oven on a very low temp, around 50. Out with the oyster mushrooms.
Oh, I think they're my favourites.
And onto this sinfully simple sweet and sour sauce.
We'll get our saucepan on over here. And our sauce is made of white wine vinegars going in.
A few generous glugs. 3 to 4 tablespoons of tomato ketchup. A couple of cloves of minced garlic. And 2 tablespoons of brown sugar.
Instantly, when you smell the vinegar with the tomato ketchup, you know this is a sweet and sour sauce. Then a dash of dark soy.
And my secret ingredient, a little tinned pineapple juice.
So now, I'm just gonna cut up tiny chunks of pineapple just to put in the sauce.
Once the pineapple is warmed through, it's done. And there you have it. How easy was that? Crispy Chinese beer battered veg and homemade sweet and sour sauce. You're welcome.
It is so, so good. It's everything that you want from a classic Chinese dish. Keep your lobster. That's my dinner.
For my main, I'm bringing the barbecue into the kitchen with this classic pork recipe.
There's one dish which we all know. It is a proper Chinese staple, a classic, char siu pork. Here's how we make the marinade. Hoisin sauce. Now, you probably recognise this flavour because you spread it on pancakes with Szechuan duck and spring onions and cucumber, and it is delicious. It's lovely like that, but it also makes a really incredible, incredible barbecue marinade.
Throw a good few tablespoons in a bowl.
Ginger, quite a lot of it. Now, this is the marinade, remember. You're also going to baste with this, and the more flavour you've got, the better it's going to taste.
A couple of mashed up garlic cloves and a tablespoon of tomato puree.
Now that's gonna help colour the meat. The redness through that is gonna give that beautiful red tone that you recognise with char siu.
Bring on the sweets with a tablespoon of honey and a teaspoon of Chinese five spice and the same of white pepper.
Then I'm gonna put in some dark soy, about a tablespoon, you don't need too much.
A splash of sesame oil, and this one is really important, Shaoxing wine.
And this is how we've always done it, we use a cap. Fill up the cap, and I'm gonna just put one cap in there.
I beg of you, get a bottle of this stuff. It gives you a Southeast Asian punch that no alternative can match.
Now wash our hands, because we are gonna get in to our meat now. And we're gonna give it a massage. So you would do somebody's feet, somebody's neck, and we're gonna really, really coat our pork tenderloin in all those beautiful flavors. Now, I would say if you can leave this in the fridge for a minimum of 4 hours, if you can overnight, and just let the flavors soak through, the longer you leave it, the more delicious it's going to be.
Cover and into the fridge, then fast forward to the following day, having dreamt about it all night long.
Right, look at this. Absolutely gorgeous. The flavour has soaked in. Don't shake it off too much. Remember, you are going to baste it. And then I'm just going to roast it off in a trivet tin like this. And then about 30 minutes into the cook, I put a water bath underneath it because all of that honey is going to start to burn and we don't want it to be burnt, and so that steam is going to help cook it. So 150 fan for about an hour and a half, maybe an hour and 40, an hour and 50, depending on your cooker.
Keep the rest of the marinade and use it to baste every 10 to 15 minutes.
I've just added a tiny bit of water in there just to loosen it up, and that's going to help baste. Okay.
Let the aroma fill the air as the richness of the pork and char siu marinade meld into the perfect roast.
Look at that! Oh, the smell is phenomenal. Sweet barbecue with all that wonderful five spice through it.
Let it rest before carving, which will give you enough time to work out how to eat it. Perfect with roast potatoes, sumptuous in a sandwich, but for me, I'm taking the road well travelled.
Nothing's changed over hundreds of years, just a bed of fluffy white rice, some soy sauce, and then some wilted choy sum. Genuinely, one of the best dishes you can have at the centre of your table. Classic, beautiful, and tasty.